In the name of the Father, the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brethren, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, who gave us the Paschal mystery in the covenant you established for reconciling the human race, to dispose our minds, we pray that what we celebrate by professing the faith, we may express in deeds through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. After the crippled man had been cured, while Peter and John were still speaking to the people, the priest, the captain of the temple guard, and the Sadducees confronted them, disturbed that they were teaching the people and proclaiming in Jesus the resurrection of the dead. They laid hands on Peter and John and put them in custody until the next day, since it was already evening. But many of those who heard the word came to believe, and the number of men grew to above 5,000. On the next day, their leaders, elders, and scribes were assembled in Jerusalem with Annas the high priest, Caiaphas, John, Alexander, and all who were of the high priestly class. They brought them into their presence and questioned them, "By what power or by what name have you done this?" Then Peter, filled with the Holy Spirit, answered them, "Leaders of the people and elders, if you are being examined today about a good deed done to a cripple, namely, by what means he was saved, then all of you and all the people of Israel should know that it was in the name of Jesus Christ, the Nazarene, whom you crucified, whom God raised from the dead. In his name, this man stands before you healed. He is the stone rejected by you, the builders, which has become the cornerstone. There is no salvation through anyone else, nor is there any other name under heaven given to the human race by which we are to be saved." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Responsorial Psalm. The stone rejected by the builders has become the cornerstone.
The stone rejected by the builders has become the cornerstone. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his mercy endures forever. Let the house of Israel say, "His mercy endures forever." Let those who fear the Lord say, "His mercy endures forever."
The stone rejected by the builders has become the cornerstone.
The stone which the builders rejected has become the cornerstone. By the Lord has this been done. It is wonderful in our eyes. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us be glad and rejoice in it.
The stone rejected by the builders has become the cornerstone.
O Lord, grant salvation. O Lord, grant prosperity. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. We bless you from the house of the Lord. The Lord is God, and he has given us light.
The stone rejected by the builders has become the cornerstone. Please all stand.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus revealed himself again to his disciples at the Sea of Tiberias. He revealed himself in this way. Together were Simon Peter, Thomas called Didymus, Nathanael from Cana in Galilee, Zebedee's sons, and two others of his disciples. Simon Peter said to them, "I am going fishing." They said to him, "We also will come with you." So they went out and got into the boat. But that night they caught nothing. When it was already dawn, Jesus was standing on the shore. But the disciples did not realize that it was Jesus. Jesus said to them, "Children, have you caught anything to eat?" They answered him, "No." So he said to them, "Cast the net over the right side of the boat, and you will find something." So they cast it and were not able to pull it in because of the number of fish. So the disciple whom Jesus loved said to Peter, "It is the Lord." When Simon Peter heard that it was the Lord, he tucked in his garment, for he was lightly clad, and jumped into the sea. The other disciples came in the boat, for they were not far from the shore, only about 100 yards, dragging the net with the fish. When they climbed out on shore, they saw a charcoal fire with fish on it and bread. Jesus said to them, "Bring some of the fish you just caught." So Simon Peter went over and dragged the net ashore, full of 153 large fish. Even though there were so many, the net was not torn. Jesus said to them, "Come, have breakfast." And none of the disciples dared to ask him, "Who are you?" because they realized it was the Lord. Jesus came over and took the bread and gave it to them, and in like manner the fish. This was now the third time Jesus was revealed to his disciples after being raised from the dead. Brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Magandang hapon po sa inyong lahat. Welcome po sa inyong lahat dito sa parokya at pambansan Dambana ni Santo Padre Pio. Peter said to other disciples, "I am going fishing." Sabi niya sa kanyang pitong kasama, "Mangingisda ako." Bumalik na muli si Peter sa kanyang dating normal na buhay, ang pangingisda. Sapagkat si Jesus ay namatay na, siya'y wala na, pero naandun ang konsensya niya. Dahil during the passion of our Lord Jesus Christ, iniwan niya, inabandon niya si Jesus. Habang si Jesus ay naghihirap, iniwanan niya si Jesus. Kaya nung iya'y mamatay, nung si Jesus ay mamatay, si Pedro, nandun ang bagabag ng lungkot sa kanyang puso sapagkat iniwanan niya sa paghihirap si Jesus. Kaya sabi niya, "I'm going fishing." Bakit? Sapagkat yun ang makakapag-relax sa kanya. Kaya nga nung sila'y nasa laot, wala siyang mahuli. Sapagkat naroon ang kanyang loneliness, naroon ang kanyang kalungkutan, yung kanyang pag-abandon sa Panginoong Diyos. Iniwanan niya. Pero salamat sa isa niyang butihing at minamahal na alagad si Juan. Siya'y kasama sa bangka. At anong magandang kanyang ginawa? Nung naroon si Juan at sila'y bumalik na muli sa pangpang, at nung makilala niya si Jesus, ang sabi niya, ang Panginoon yon. Tuwang-tuwa muli ang mga alagad sapagkat habang sila'y nasa laot at nangingisda, lungkot na lungkot, di nila akalain na pagdating sa pangpang, nandun pala si Jesus at nag-aantay sa kanila. Kaya naandun, kaya anong ginawa ni Peter? Siya'y tumalon sa bangka, tumalon sapagkat siya'y hubad. Naroon muli yung kanyang paggalang, yung muling pagmamahal na kanyang naramdaman sa Panginoong Diyos. Kaya mga minamahal na mga kapatid, una nating refleksyon, pwedeng pagnilayan. Kapag tayo'y nasa matinding kasalanan dahil ramdam natin ay iniwanan natin ang Diyos, anong pamaraan at ang gagawin mo para kang muling makabalik sa Diyos? Anong gagawin mo para muli kang makabalik sa Diyos? Si Peter may kaibigan na muling nagsama sa kanya at nagpakilala muli. Ang Panginoon yon. Padalwa, anong gagawin mo para kang makabalik? Minsan, aantayin mo bang ang Diyos pang muli ang magpabalik sa iyo sa Panginoon? Pag ikay nagkamali, nagkasala sa Diyos, no? Ikay napalayo sa Kanya, minsan ang Diyos gagawa rin ng paraan para mapabalik ka. At siya gagawin din ng maraming tao para ikaw ay bumalik sa Panginoong Diyos. Ang tanong, babalik ka ba? No? Bakit ka pababalikin ng Diyos? Sapagkat ayaw kanyang mawala. Pagdating ni Peter doon sa pangpang, nandun yung siga, yung apoy, sila'y nag-aalmusal. Hali kayo, mag-almusal kayo. Kita ni Pedro yung apoy na yon. Sapagkat habang siya'y naaalaala niya, habang siya'y nagpapainit, siya'y tinanong, di ba ikaw ang kasama ng taong ito? Anong sabi niya? Hindi ko po siya kilala. Pero ngayon, itong apoy na ito, sabi ni Jesus, hali kayo, mag-almusal tayo. Hindi na fire of betrayal, kundi fire of mercy na itong apoy na ito. Kaya mga minamahal na mga kapatid, ano? Pag tayo napapalayo sa Diyos, ang Diyos gagawa ng pamaraan para tayo bumalik sa Kanya. Minsan, apoy ang ginagamit ng Diyos para tayo mapabalik. Minsan, masasakit na pamaraan. Pero yan ay fire of mercy. No? Minsan, ganyan ang gagamitin ng Diyos para bumalik ka sa Kanya. At siya'y nag-o-offer, halika, nasa isang siga, na isang apoy. No? At magandang pagnilayan natin, mga minamahal na mga kapatid yan, no? Na pag ganyan ang ginagamit ng Diyos sa atin, yung fire of mercy, apoy ng awa, no? Talagang ikaw ay padadaanin sa pain, sa matitinding struggle, sa matitinding pagsubok. Tawag yan ay apoy ng awa ng Diyos sa tao. Pero, papunta yan sa Diyos. Yan ay purification process mo. No? Ang gusto ng Diyos, makabalik ka, mapurify ka. Kaya ang tanong, nandiyan ka ba ngayon sa fire of mercy ng Diyos? Nasa purification process ka ba? No? Kaya mga minamahal ng kapatid, tingnan ninyo, anong pinakamagandang fire of mercy? Anong sabi ni Jesus? Hali kayo, mag-almusal tayo. Ang misa, ang banal na Eucharistia. Yan ang pinakamagandang purification natin. Kaya, lagi niyong linisin ang inyong konsensya at ang inyong puso sa pagtanggap sa banal na Eucharistia. Sapagkat yan ang tunay na magpupurify sa ating puso, si Jesus yan. Kaya kung ikaw ay dumadaan ngayon sa matinding apoy ng pagsubok sa buhay, gusto kang dalhin ni Jesus sa Eucharist. Yan ang tunay na magpupurify sa ating lahat.
For your offerings in the envelope, you may drop them at the collection baskets. Please all stand.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept this sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy church.
Perfect within us, O Lord, we pray, the solemn exchange brought about by these paschal offerings, that we may be drawn from earthly desires to a longing for the things of heaven, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord. But in this time, above all, to lead you yet more gloriously. When Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed, through Him, the children of light rise to eternal life, and the halls of heavenly kingdom are thrown open to the faithful. For His death is our ransom from death, and His rising, the life of all has risen. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic host sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Who cannot kneel, please remain standing with reverence.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Gilbert, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them to the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her most chaste spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honors is yours forever and ever.
Let us all stand.
Let us all pray the Lord's Prayer. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Those who cannot kneel, please remain standing with reverence.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold Him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. The second collection, which will be done, is for the continuing development of the parish and National Shrine of St. Father Pio, and for the needs and welfare of the sick, and retired priest of the Archdiocese of Lipa. Thank you for your offering. Let us all stand.
Let us pray. Keep safe, O Lord, we pray, those whom you have saved by your kindness, that redeemed by the passion of your Son, they may rejoice in his resurrection, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen. Prayer for intercession to Saint Padre Pio. All together, Padre Pio, holy monk from Pietrelcina, outstanding saint of the present era, our bright beacon on this earthly pilgrimage, our sanctuary in times of trouble, holy exemplar of great courage, with you our needs do we confide, as well as our livelihood, our health, and our might. Unworthy as we are, we pray that you conceive. Bless and grace us that our lives may be fulfilled. From sin may we abstain, in God may we remain. We also beseech thee, servant of the Most Holy, to instruct us in the gospel, that we may reflect and believe. Our requests are before thee. Our hearts repent, resolving earnestly to not sin again, to always follow God the Father, together with the Spirit, and Jesus the Mediator. Amen. Please be seated for some announcements. Una, sa inyong pagdalaw sa pambansang Dambana, mangyaring pakaingatan ang inyong mga personal na gamit. Hangad namin ang isang matiwasay at maayos na pagbisita sa National Shrine. Ikalawa, sa pagnanais nating palawakin ang dokumentasyon at datos ng mga pilgrims and devotees na bumibisita sa pambansang Dambana, kami po ay nag-aanyaya sa inyong lahat na makilahok sa ginagawang pagkalakap ng impormasyon na makakatulong sa pagpapaunlad ng ating turismong pangsimbahan. Makikisuyo po kami na paki-scan ang QR code na inyong makikita sa paligid ng simbahan at pakikumpleto ng mga impormasyong kinakailangan. Makakaasa po kayo sa aming pag-iingat ng private impormasyon na inyong ibabahagi bilang pagsunod sa batas ng Data Privacy Act of 2012. Ang inyong pakikiisa ay malaking tulong at susi sa tagumpay ng proyektong ito sa karangalan ng Mahal na Birhen sa ganap na 5 ng umaga. Nasisimula natin sa harap ng Fountain of Hope. Ang mga sasama ay inaanyayahang magdala ng kandila. Maraming salamat po at mangyaring panatilihin natin ang kalinisan, katahimikan at diwa ng pananalangin sa loob at labas ng ating mga simbahan. Magsitayo na po ang lahat para sa pagbabasbas na religious articles.
Mga kapatid, manalangin tayo sa Diyos Amang makapangyarihan upang tayo maging kawangis ni Kristo sa taimtim na pagdalangin sa tulong ng mga larawan at mga dasalan. pong ilabas ang inyong mga pabeblesan. O Panginoong Diyos, ikaw ang bukal ng lahat ng pagkapala at biyaya. Ibuhos mo ang iyong bendisyon sa mga gamit na ito, sa pananalangin, mga rosaryo, mga imahin, mga dasalan na nagpapaalaala ng iyong kabutihan, kabanal at pagmamahal sa amin, upang ang lahat ng dumulog at magdasal gamit ang mga ito ay magtamo ng iyong awat biyaya. Loobin mong tularan nawa nila ang kabanal at aral ng Panginoon at ng mga santo magpasawalang hanggan.
Amen. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed art you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed art you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed art you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless us all, the Father, the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass has been offered. Let us go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord.